Today, we're going to show you how to configure I/O via the IoT Edge Gateway and monitor the status. Access the gateway and log in. Go to Edge Computing I/O module page, and you will see the I/O list. From top to bottom, there are 4 DIs and 4 DOs. Under the list, you can configure Modbus TCP Slave so that you can remotely monitor I/O status. First, let us show you how to configure DI. Click the Edit button of any DI. DI mode supports digital input and counter. In the mode of digital input, there are 2 wiring methods, dry contact and wet contact wiring, where the electrode levels of DI are recorded. In the mode of counter, the number of pulses received by DI is recorded. We can set the initial value of the counter and choose whether to store value in the case of power failure. Here, we just select the default. When DI is set as counter, it stops counting by default. Click Start, and it begins recording the number of pulses it receives. Click Stop to stop it from recording the number of pulses received. Click Reset to reset the counting as the initial value. Next, we will show how to configure DO. Click Edit of any DO. The DO mode supports digital output, continuous pulse output, and fixed total pulse output. Digital output refers to output of high and low electrical levels. In the mode of digital output, we can choose if DO status is maintained in power failure. Continuous pulse output mode means cyclical pulse output. Output frequency and duty cycle can be adjusted through low and high signal widths. Fixed total pulse output means output of fixed number of cyclical pulses. The number of output pulses can be restricted. Take continuous pulse output as an example. We set low and high signal widths at 1000 respectively, which is 1 second for each. Therefore, the output frequency is 5 Hz with a duty cycle of 50%. After the configuration is submitted, input is stopped by default. Click Start and enable continue output of pulse signals and click Stop to stop it. Next, we will show how to configure Modbus TCP Slave. Parameters are displayed after Modbus TCP Slave is enabled. When external access is enabled, PCs and other external devices can monitor the I/O status of the gateway with the connection information of Modbus TCP. While when it is disabled, the gateway's I/O status cannot be monitored. Port number, slave address, and byte order are the connection information of Modbus TCP. Please note that the port number cannot be in conflict with other programs or functions. The maximum number of TCP connections refers to the maximum number of Modbus TCP connections supported, which can be submitted after the configuration is completed. Switch to Modbus Mapping Table page. Here we can see the monitoring information of I/O status, which includes coils status and holding registers. We can see the status name, data type, register address, and read-write permission of each I/O. Next, we will show how to read the I/O status in the coil status with device supervisor agent. Go to Device Supervisor Measure Monitor page and add a Modbus TCP controller. The IP address is the loopback address 172.0.0.1, port number is 1502, and slave address is 1. Leave other parameters as default. Click Confirm. Next, add measuring points under the added controller. Keep the register address, data type, and read-write permission consistent with DO1 status in the Modbus mapping table, and leave all the parameters as default. Click Confirm. When the configuration is effective, we can see the value of the current DO1 is 0. Change it into 1 and return to the I/O module. Now we can see the value of DO1 is 1. Here we have completed I/O configuration of IoT Edge Gateway and started monitoring the I/O status.
For more information, please visit inhandgo.com.